Hi there, Florin here. Today I want to do something that many PC users might get shivers while thinking about it. I want to delete my CPU, an i7-4790K, and replace that shitty thermal paste that Intel decided to use inside there. Lately I've encountered some serious issues with the thermals on my CPU. I usually do video rendering and I found myself not being able to finish my work since the CPU started overheating. The quick fix solution was to disable the turbo on my CPU from BIOS. This brought my thermals below 90 degrees Celsius range, at about 70 to 80 degrees. But this wasn't good enough. I've paid for the CPU to have some certain specifications and I suddenly can't use it. At first I was like, okay, the cooler is not mounted properly. So I've started to put it in all kinds of positions, but this without any luck. And here I'm talking about a Corsair H80i water cooler. Maybe after 3 years the cooler might be failing on me. So I decided to buy another cooler, a Cooler Master Hyper 212X. Same problem, the CPU started overheating and I couldn't do my job. I also took into consideration voltages, but this path led to nowhere. Then came the last resort. I had to face my fears and delete my CPU. By the way, I never had any problems like this with my old AMD CPU, an FX8350. This bad boy ran like a beast at 4GHz and it was gaming at 55 degrees Celsius on my old Corsair H80i cooler. This Intel CPU was like 74 degrees in Battlefield 4 with the same cooler. And imagine my frustration when everybody on the internet was taunting how hot the AMD CPUs are and how cool the Intel is. Important notice. Before we start, remember to tie some grounded wires before working on the CPU. Static electricity is a pain in the ass. Let's get to work. First thing we need to do is to take out the CPU, obviously. Next, be sure to have everything ready next to you. The thermal paste, a cloth, some napkins, isopropylic alcohol to clean the CPU, and some silicone glue, this one is optional. And is ready to be good till 150 degrees Celsius. Now we have to position the CPU into the vise. I got this yesterday specially for this project. It was around 30 euros. First you need to put the piece of cloth below the vise. This is to have something soft below if any part of the CPU comes flying. You have to fix the CPU at an angle. One side touches the heat spreader and the other side touches the CPU PCB. When turning the lever, you'll encounter very little force, but remember to do this slowly. There is no point in hurrying. The IHS will part easily from the die. As you can see, Intel did a marvelous job with the thermal paste that is now hardened to a crust. We have to clean the heat spreader from the old paste and adhesive. Next, we have to clean the CPU. Be gentle on this one. I found out that my nails are the best tool to do this delicate operation. Now I'm marking the position of the heat spreader on the CPU so I know where to put it when I finish. Apply thermal paste. I'm using Arctic MX4, but some people recommend using Cool Laboratories Liquid Pro on the CPU die. I choose not to do this because that paste conducts electricity and the CPU has some components next to the die inside there. For a few degrees I don't want to risk it. Now I put the silicone on the heat spreader and I apply it with care, taking into consideration my markings. Be sure to clean the CPU on the contact side with alcohol. There might be some dirt around there. When I was installing the CPU back on the motherboard, I had to push the IHS with my thumb because the silicone didn't have time to harden. After this, you clean everything with alcohol, put some paste and then mount the cooler and see if it works. As you can see, my cat is already curious if my PC will work after this. So, let's check it out.
Okay, so the moment of truth has come. Let's see if she boots up. Waiting. There she goes!
As you can see, the temperature in the BIOS already shows lower values than what I had before at the same room temperature. Moving on to video rendering, and the same pattern can be found here. Up to 10 degrees lower after the Delid, judging by the max temperature reading. Using an even better thermal paste will bring even better results, but like I've said, I didn't want to push my luck. Moving to gaming, you can also see a decrease in temperature. All of this while using an air cooler Cooler Master 212X on a silent profile. Disclaimer, I'm not responsible for any damages you might be doing to your CPU after watching this video. That's it for now. See ya next time.